So let's take this understanding of earned value forward. As we saw, that red line is indicating actual cost, the green line is representing earned value, and blue line remains as planned value. So what we got, we earned $70 from the day one. Now we can calculate some of the variances to understand how are we performing looking at this particular data. Just looking at earned value, planned value, or actual cost is a first level calculation. The second level calculation can be done by calculating some variances. So let's look at cost related variances first. So when we talk about variance, we can say a cost variance, it's more about how much we earn and how much we spent. Simple. So the first thing is, as a formula, is earned value minus actual cost. And that makes sense as well. We earned 70 and we spent 120. For this particular case, cost variance was minus 50. Earned value minus actual cost. And we also have something called cost performance index. We call it CPI, which is also representing the information in a different way, earned value divided by actual cost, which means 0.70 divided by 120 comes near to 0.58. So you have 0.58. Now what does it represent? As a formula point of view, if you want to remember as a PMP exam test taker, all these variances, the first figure is earned value. That's it. So cost variance, earned value. Cost performance index, earned value. Earned value is the source of all the information. Now, if it is about cost, the second figure is actual cost. If it is about schedule, the second figure would be planned value. We are going there. So when the CPI, the cost performance index, shows that we are earning against spending. And if my cost performance index is telling me 0.58, it means I am spending $1 and I am getting value of 58 cents. That's it. It's like my performance is 42% behind, more or less. If I would have got one, it means I'm getting maximum value of, I'm getting planned value of my money. If I would have installed 20 machines rather than 10, and by just spending $100, my schedule cost performance index would have been 2, because my earning was 200 and my actual cost could have been 100. So anything, if our cost performance index is less than 1, it shows inefficient utilization of our money as per budget. And if it is more than 1, it shows that we are doing far better as far as using our money than our budget. Now, how much less than 1? It also shows the similar amount of inefficiency. If it is 0.5, it shows that we are getting 50 cents out of $1. We are that behind. If it is 0.2, it shows that we are getting 20 cents out of $1. So this is how we can make sense by using cost performance index. Now we also have something, schedule variances. We call it earned value minus planned value. In this particular case, 70 minus 100 is equals to minus 30. Similarly, we have a schedule performance index, which is like earned value divided by planned value. In this case, 70 divided by 100, it is like 0.7. So it's like how much percentage we have completed work against the plan. So a 0.7 shows that we have completed 70% of the planned work. And that is what the schedule performance index tells. It primarily tells at this point in time how much percentage we have completed the planned work. If it is more than 1, it means we have completed more than planned work. It has nothing to do directly with the actual cost. You see, the actual cost is not here. It is only about earned value and planned value. So we planned to have 100, but we earned 70. Now, if we do 20 machine, our earned value would have been 200, irrespective of actual cost, because cost is somewhere going in a cost performance index. So we use schedule performance index to identify how as a percentage wise, how much percentage we are completing our work against the plan. And we use cost performance index and cost variances to figure it out how well we are making use of our money. In general, the earned value management focus a lot on cost related monitoring, and you will see a cost performance index becoming quite frequently seen in various practice tests in various measurements when we look at control cost related topics. Yeah, and we will look into some of the forecasting things in the next video, but this is what we wanted to talk as far as variances are concerned.